Hello friends, welcome to my channel. Today we are going to learn what's the difference between Ansible, RAW, Shell and command modules. First we will discuss about command module. Using command module, we can execute shell command on the remote client machine and we can see the Ansible result. So in my case, my Ansible control node is host A and my client machine is host C. Let me execute attack command via Ansible command module and see the result. Ansible, then host C. For module, we have to use the keyword, the option -m, then command. So you can mention the command, the bracket -a space, for example, uptime. And we can see we got the result. The remote host uptime, I got that. So next we are going to discuss limitation of the command module. There is a few limitation in the command module. For example, we cannot use redirect or pipe symbol in the command module. Also, the Python is mandatory for the command module. And this command module will not use the remote host, remote user environment variable. So this is the limitation of the command module. To overcome the command module limitation, next we are going to use shell module. For example, in command module, if I'm using the like redirect symbol, and we can see what we are going to get. So let me execute this command and we can see I'm getting the option like this option is not available. So non-return code is zero. So this is the limitation in the command module. We cannot use pipe or redirect, that kind of stream function we cannot use. Next we will discuss about Ansible shell module. Using shell module, we can execute remote command on client machine. Let me explain few benefits of the shell module. We can able to use redirect or pipe symbol via shell module. It use the remote user environment variable. Also, it will use the shell like /bin/sh by default. For example, if you want to execute the redirect symbol, let me show you. Ansible, remote host, then -m for module, then we have to type module name shell. Then -a lscpu pipe -n space file. Let me see the result. And we can see here we have using the pipe symbol. Let me execute one more command. We can use uptime /tmp/uptime. .txt. Here we don't see any result because it is stored on the remote host. So here I am using the redirect symbol. Let me log into the remote host and get the redirected output file. And we can see the result. So these are the benefits of the shell module. But command module and shell module, Python is mandatory to execute command on the remote host. Why? Because both the module will use the Python interpreter to convert whatever giving the command into the system understandable code. So Python is mandatory for both the case. Finally, we'll discuss about RAW module. RAW module also same, but it will not use the Python for the remote execution. It will use normal standard SSH connection. For example, if you have the data center, you might have the multiple system like embedded system, like network switches, like appliance possible to connect via SSH. That device don't have the Python. For that kind of situation, you can execute remote command using SSH connectivity via Ansible. For that case, RAW module will be really helpful and it is one of the powerful module. The key difference is that Ansible does not do any error checking like standard error, standard out, return code for the RAW modules. So let me execute RAW module via attack command and see the result. Ansible, my remote host will be on host C. -m for module. I am using RAW module. Then I am using the command. We can see it is giving the result, but without Python. It just executing the RAW command on the target host via SSH connectivity, and it is giving me the result. Next, the same result we can get it via like normal SSH. For that, we have to use SSH host C in double quotation. We can execute that command, and we can see. So both are doing the actually same kind of function without Python. So if you want to see the more about this, how it is not using the Python. Let me show you without Python how the raw module is working. So I'm logging to my remote host to see and execute which Python. So my Python is in this location. So let me move this file into different name. So I'm moving this initializable path into different name. Also there is a one more path which with the version I'm removing both. Now go back to my Ansible host and execute my Ansible command module and see the result. So it is clearly giving that the Python interpreter is not available in the system and it is giving the error. So from this we can understand that Ansible command and schedule module always require Python. So to overcome that we are using raw module. So let me execute the same command with the raw module. So this is the benefit of the raw module. So also this is one of the interview question. I hope you like this video. Thanks for watching.